I did a video like this back in July, 2016. Yeah, July 2016. And unfortunately, not a lot of people were satisfied about it. So I'm going to make an update video for you guys on how to program your Traxxas ESC. This is going to be using the Traxxas XL-5 system. But for those of you who own the EVX2 ESC that's found on the Traxxas Emax and the Summit, or probably the eRevo as well, the brushed eRevo. And for those of you who owns the Valenion VXL system, this will work the same thing as the XL5. So anyways, let's get started. The first thing you need to do is to turn on your transmitter. In this case, I'm using my onboard audio slash, as you can see. Okay, so we're gonna do the three main programming choices. You have the standard mode, which will give you full forward and full reverse and full braking. And then we got the second one, which is the race mode, which you have full forward, full brake, but no reverse. And then you got the third one, which is training mode, which is basically the same thing as the standard mode, full forward and full reverse and full braking, but your top speed is limited. So I'll explain more about that later once we get there. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to press the easy set button and hold it until you see one blink. And one blink of the red light, when you see the red light blink once, you're in standard mode or sport mode, that's what I want to call it. Now we'll give you full forward and full reverse. Ooh. So once again, full forward, full brake, full reverse. The next thing we're gonna do is the race mode. That's the second one. You're gonna do the same thing as what you did with the first mode, but you're gonna hold it until you see two red blinking lights. Oops, hold on. Made a mistake here. There's two red blinking lights. So you have full forward, full brake, but no reverse. Full forward, full brake, no reverse. There you go. That's race mode. Now, the final thing, the final programming, or final mode, I should say, is training mode. Now, the training mode is basically, like I said, full forward and full reverse. Same thing which you get on the normal standard mode, but on training mode, your top speed is limited. So let's say if you have the speed gearing setting, the slash will go maybe 30, 35 miles an hour. If you turn on the training mode, you're only limited to, let's say, 25 to 27 miles an hour. It could be faster though than just that. I'm just giving you guys an estimation or just a valid explanation here. So anyways, same thing as what you've done with the standard mode and race mode. You're gonna hold it, hold until you see three blinking red lights. So you get half forward, full brake, and half reverse. So it's perfect for people who are new to the hobby, or just little children who wants to get used to the new, 35 miles an hour RCs without having to, go crazy at it at the first go. So they need to, it's basically something, basically like taking baby steps before you go up to top speed. So Training modes, top speed on a, you know, on a slasher rustler. It's basically the same top speed as one of those new bright cars that have lithium batteries on them. So maybe around 15, 20 miles an hour. Not too bad, though. So, let me switch it back to train to standard mode, because I like driving on standard mode. All right, the next thing we're going to be I'm going to be showing you is the how to turn on the low voltage detection. And this is for those of you who own LiPos. Keep in mind, this will not handle 3S LiPo. This will only handle 2S LiPos, okay? 7.4 volts. And 7.2 volts is almost a similar voltage. So, anyways, to turn on the low voltage detection, we're gonna hold the easy set button once you see the red light, you're gonna let go. And after that, you're gonna push it again. Once you hear that, you're gonna see the green light turn on. You'll hear the beeps first, and then once you turn it on again, you'll see the green light. The green light means you're in low voltage detection. So this will only work on LiPos. With nickel metal hydrides, you're not gonna be driving for very long. Hopefully that will clarify that. Anyways. Alright, the last thing I'm going to be showing you guys is to turn off the low voltage detection. The same thing as what we done when we turn it on, but we're just going to do the opposite. So basically, hold it until you see the red light. Push it again. Until you hear tones. There you go. Now you're on low. Now low voltage detection is now turned off. So we're gonna try to turn this thing on. There you go. Now you're on low voltage detection. Low voltage detection is now off. All right. So I guess that's about it for now. Hopefully this is a much better video. If it's not, I will try to make more updates on this so you guys can get used to it. Because I know when I did my previous one back in 2016, I knew a lot of people didn't really like that, so I decided to make a new one. Hopefully this will work again. And if it does, hit the like button. If it doesn't, hit the thumbs down button. Doesn't matter what. I appreciate your feedback, and I will. Helps me improve on my videos in the later future. So anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that. And like I said, I hope you guys may get this one better than my other one. So, yeah. That's about it. For those of you guys who own the VXL, Villaneon, or the EVX2, this will work the same way as the XL5.